deeper and stronger customer relationships. We know where we need to go with this. Let's start by learning more about the generations that compose our workforce. Born before 1946, traditionalists were shaped and strongly influenced by the struggles of the Depression era and World War II. Food, cash, and jobs were scarce. Families were close-knit. Education was often a luxury. These folks weren't looking for a dream career or personal fulfillment. They came home from the service looking for any work they could find to protect their loved ones from poverty. Today, traditionalists account for less than 16% of our total population. And while theirs is a group that has greatly faded from the forefront, the values these loyal, patriotic, hard-working individuals espoused still resonate on many levels. Think of your father, or more likely at this point, grandfather or great-grandfather. Tremendous forces of the Depression and the war instilled in them a respect for authority, security, honor. You looked a man in the eyes when you spoke to him. You sacrificed self for country, family, and possibly a company. It's perfectly reasonable then that we would expect traditionalists to favor top-down management, modeled after the military. Very stable and detail-oriented. They're uncomfortable with change, conflicts, and ambiguity. This is a generation that places great stead in face-to-face communication, the wisdom of experience, recognition through handwritten notes and mementos. As we lose more of this generation to time, I think we also lose sight of the wonderful assets they contributed to our lives. Great integrity, selflessness, security. In our work and personal lives, there are things we can do to be more effective communicators with traditionalists and with people whose work styles have been shaped by this group. When meeting or talking with a traditionalist, respect them, be courteous and on time, honor chain of command, and be accountable for your actions. And now, we'll talk about a group that tends to see the world as its oyster. The Me Generation is next. Born between 1946 and 1964, baby boomers make up about one-third of the population. Unlike the traditionalists, boomers grew up in prosperous and competitive times. The economy was flourishing. Jobs were abundant. Bigger was better. Bigger houses, bigger cars, bigger paychecks. Boomers were driven to excel at their jobs not so much out of duty and honor to the company mission, but out of a burning desire to get ahead. Think of it this way. The floodgates have been opened. The only thing holding a boomer back from financial success would be him or herself. In a word, workaholics. In fact, out of habit and a concern for financial security, many boomers are delaying retirement until the age of 80. They're the first ones in the office and the last to leave. Hardworking, self-sacrificing, service-oriented. They're earning their way up the corporate ladder and demand respect for their knowledge and experience. They want to be viewed as mentors, working with a high degree of independence. They're problem solvers who put process ahead of results, with less focus on budgets and actual costs. Higher education has taught them the importance of being politically correct and cognizant of the human equation in business. But that doesn't make the reality of dealing with differing views any easier. Boomers are uncomfortable with conflict and opposing opinions. Rather than embrace new technology, they tend to hoard information by avoiding social media, relying instead on face-to-face discussions and phone calls. To them, attention from a supervisor could be seen as micromanaging or indicative of a lack of trust. While money, titles, and power may be the ultimate rewards, don't overlook the importance of traditional recognition too. Trophies, plaques, certificates, and public acknowledgement. Baby boomers are excellent workers, managers, and individuals. To establish a common ground with this group, don't be politically incorrect. Ignore their contributions or tell instead of asking. Do value their experiences, give them credit and perks, and redefine retirement along with them. So, Who's giving baby boomers a run for their money? Here comes the latchkey generation, Generation X. Born between 1965 and 1978, Gen X accounts for about 20% of our population. More than half have earned a post-secondary degree and 43% have at least a bachelor's degree, which may help explain why they feel penned in by baby boomers and threatened by younger, up-and-coming generations with less formal education but more street savvy. As the latchkey generation, Gen Xers grew up fending for themselves as one or both parents worked. More than anything, Gen Xers have seen their parents devote their lives to their jobs. They also want to succeed, but on a more personal basis. For them, work-life balance means an ability to pay the bills while acquiring new skills and earning more time to enjoy life outside the office. This group has seen how work has cut into their parents' and families' lives. Through new technology and systems, they feel confident in moving forward with projects, taking on challenges with a great degree of freedom, and working in an autonomous manner. Adaptable, tech savvy, and not limited or intimidated by authority, the Gen Xer views interaction with a supervisor as validation. Fewer rules, flexibility, creativity. Gen Xers believe in competence and earned respect. And while communication through emails and working from home may suit them best, there can be a downside to this independent work style. Lack of face-to-face collaboration can cause Gen X to be impatient, inexperienced, and lacking in people skills. They crave recognition, money, and extra time off. But sometimes they're unwilling to go through the paces required to achieve this success. What do we need to remember when it comes to Gen X? Don't micromanage, talk too much, or treat them as slackers. Provide fast feedback, help them develop their social skills, and groom them for management. Say hello to millennials, also known as Generation Y, and the Internet generation. They've been called Generation X on Fast Forward, with self-esteem on steroids. It's easy to communicate with a millennial born between 1979 and 1995, as long as you have a smartphone, belong to a social network, and aren't too hung up on talking face-to-face. An incredible and emerging force in today's workplace, millennials make up about 30% of our population. This creative, visual, and technologically advanced group is all about challenges and multitasking. If previous generations were driven by loyalty, ambition, and work-life balance, millennials are most influenced by the individual attention they received from their parents. Self-confidence, optimism, and tenacity are the key words here. Millennials really represent a radical departure from the traits we've normally associated with our most valuable employees. They thrive on change and don't conform to accepted norms such as the idea that long hours equal greater productivity. Frankly, they work because they enjoy social interaction and the paycheck that supports their interests outside the office. Millennials expect their relationship with a supervisor to be one of collaboration, focusing on results and competence, not tenure. With a great degree of self-confidence, people in this group expect and demand rewards for performance, salary increases and bonuses, advancement opportunities, time off, and recognition are part of the job description. Otherwise, the millennial employee has no problem moving on. Understand that what appears to be an ultra-healthy ego also masks a true lack of experience. Millennial employees can be wonderfully optimistic and enthusiastic, a real asset. They just require a little more structure and supervision. When dealing with a millennial, focus on this. Don't treat them like children and expect long hours. Do provide training and mentors. Keep them busy and support their multitasking abilities. Well, if you thought we were done with the generations, think again. Today, there's a new group entering the workforce, referred to as Generation Z, or the I generation. This newest group was born after 1995. At nearly 70 million strong, Generation Z makes up more than 25% of the U.S. population, with millions of them in their early 20s and beginning to enter the workforce. This up-and-coming group is on the leading edge of the digital age. They grew up immersed in technology in the era of smartphones, Facebook, and Netflix. They're open to non-traditional forms of learning. They know how to self-educate and are skilled at finding the information they need and want. Like millennials, Gen Z are confident and eager to learn new skills. They seek work environments that foster mentoring and prefer a teaching style of leadership. They envision working for companies that stand for something and offer a balance of flexible schedules and work environments. In the coming years, as millions more of them transition into the labor force, we'll continue to learn what motivates Generation Z and their work preferences. We hope this overview of generations has shed some light on changing faces in the workplace. Recognizing how upbringing, culture, and values affect our work styles gives us a greater opportunity to engage employees on a meaningful basis. It's a way to manage differences in conflict, build a productive team, and accentuate the positives that make a group of diverse individuals a stronger whole.